In sport, my name is Adam Geiger, alongside Braden Konshu, getting set for the final of this regional. The winner is off to the CIS Final Eight next weekend. The University of Regina Cougars and the Laurier Golden Hawks. Braden, both these teams winning last night. The Cougars again coming back like they always do. Laurier from start to finish. But this team, the Golden Hawks, might present a matchup problem here for the Cougars.
Yeah, absolutely. Number 23, Krista Mancino. She's definitely a player to watch for the Golden Hawks down low. With Brittany Reed and Ann Mercer on the bench, as they have been all season long for the Cougars, it's going to be tough for them to deal with her down low.
And for the Cougars all year long, it's been slow starts. I got to think it's important for them to start fast.
Well, Dave Taylor was quoted in today's Leaders Post as saying, Joe just thinks that's the style of our team, referring to Zalchak. It's just the way they've always done it and just the way they're going to continue to do it. At some point, you got to think it might come back to bite them, but until then, the Cougars are going to go with what's brought them here.
Should be a beauty. Tip-off coming up next.
For the final game of the West Round 1 Regional of the CIS Women Basketball Championship. Tonight we have the University of Regina Cougars taking on the Wilfrid Laurier University Golden Hawks. Tonight's winner will join the four conference champions from Atlantic Canada, Quebec, Ontario, and Canada West, as well as the host University of Windsor Lancers. The CIS Women's Final Eight will now compete for a national championship title. We now ask you to please rise, remove your headwear, and join us in singing the Canadian National Anthem.
A spot in the CIS National Tournament on the line. And it all gets started right about now. The Cougars wearing the gold. And the Laurier Golden Hawks
in purple, wearing your favorite purple jerseys.
Well, this game should be a gem. It's going to be key for the Cougars, I think, to start off fast. Hasn't been the case so far this year, really, for this team, but they do get the opening tip. It's Joanna Zalaschak for the Cougars. Danny Schmidt, of course, if you didn't catch last night's game, absolutely went off. We'll talk about that, but it's Lettingham to get this one started. Nice cut to the hole for two.
I don't know if the Cougars do get off to a good start here, Adam. It's going to be uncharted territory for this team, really. They may not know what to do with a second quarter lead.
Here's Laurier looking to come right back after the Cougars score. But out of bounds, the basketball will be turned over. For Laurier, Braden, they struggled offensively in that game against Uquam yesterday, so it's going to be important for them to stick with the Cougars here, who can score. Zalaschak for three, back rim. Chamberlain, offensive board. Geiston thought about it, now puts it up. That's off the back of the rim. Almost got the roll. Now, the Golden Hawks into the front court.
Felicia Mazzaro with the ball here for Laurier. She's a fun player to watch at, and we got introduced to her yesterday.
Just a first-year player as well, and talk post-game about having a few nerves, but handling them quite well with that win over Uquam. Now a miss and a rebound picked up by Zalaschak. She'll run the floor right between two defenders. And as it poked away from behind, quick hands there by Mazarol. Now Felicia up across the timeline. Driving shot there is off the mark for Adamczyk. Out of bounds. Stick it right here with Laurier. They will have 16 to shoot.
Adamczyk, also a player to watch for these Wilfrid Laurier Golden Hawks. OUA first team all-star this year.
Here's Mancino outside the three-point line. Comes up top to Grant. Swing it around into the hands of Kohlmeier. Six to shoot. She'll put it up from three. Front rim, but it's Mancino with the rebound. 2-0 Cougars here. 8:20 left in the first quarter. Second chance opportunity here for the Golden Hawks, pardon me. Into the hands of Mazarol, leaving her open are the Cougars. Now it comes into the paint. And a foul there. Two free throws coming up for Adamczyk.
Adamczyk, 2 for 2 from the line yesterday, shooting 71% this year.
The Cougars with the big win over UBIC yesterday, a 10-point win. And a 10-point win for Laurier as well over Uquam. First free throw up and good.
Adamczyk had a double-double last night for the Golden Hawks, 12 points, 10 rebounds. She's from Greensville, Ontario, which is just outside of Hamilton.
Second free throw, rattles in and out. Rebound picked up by Lettingham. Her two-point bucket earlier in this quarter has the Cougars up 2-1. 8 minutes left in the first quarter here. It's Lettingham again. Way away from the basket, gets it down low to Schmidt. Now Danny has to go down and retrieve a loose ball, but it's out of bounds off the Cougars.
Danny Schmidt wide open on that pass of Lettingham. Lettingham's pass went a little bit astray. She used her left hand there. I think just kind of got a little bit off in the release there and threw right to the Wilfrid Laurier player.
Mancino, open look for the lead, and she rips it. 3-2, Golden Hawks out in front, 7:33 to play in the opening quarter.
Yeah, we saw Mancino. She's a threat from the perimeter as well, Adam. She was 1 for 2 from the three-point line last night against Uquam.
Chamberlain inside, counted for two. Cougars retake the lead, 4-3 now. Here's Mazarol, near wing. Up top, Grant inside that three-point line. It's short. Lettingham grabs another rebound. Here comes Zalaschak. She runs the floor, leads the charge. Geiston gets the pass and goes up for two.
Nice little fast break by the Cougars. Joanna Zalaschak run on the floor, hitting Gabby Geiston for the open layup. So Gabby's on the board. Took it till the fourth quarter to get her first points yesterday. Only takes her 3 minutes into this game to get her first score tonight.
Nice drive by Kohlmeier. That'll give her two free throws. Of course, Zalaschak with an assist on that fast break there. Came up one assist short yesterday of a triple-double. Kohlmeier to the free throw line.
And of course, head coach Dave Taylor pointed out she was just a couple of turnovers shy of making that a quadruple-double. As any coach doesn't really like the turnovers would tell you.
First free throw was good as Colmeyer looks to make it a 2-for-2 trip. And she knocks down both. 6-5 Cougars, 6:48 left first quarter. Joanna into the front court. Cougars looking for a spot in the CIS National Championships next weekend. Of course, Laurier looking for the same thing. There's the ball down, low tipped away. Off the Golden Hawks, so keep it right here with 9 seconds to shoot.
Yeah, the winner of this game gets birth to next weekend's Final Eight. One of these regionals already completed, the CIS East Regional hosted by UNB. Toronto took a 65-57 victory over Western Ontario. So the Varsity Blues will be in Windsor next weekend.
Danny Schmidt misses an easy jump shot. Maybe get her outside the three-point line where she was 5-for-5 last night. And see if Danny can't get it going from beyond the arc. 6-5 Cougars right now. Mancino's going to try for three, and she connects. Brayden, you mentioned even last night that she's going to be a big matchup problem for the Cougars. And so far, it's Mancino leading the charge. So she will shoot two. And it's Laurier out in front for the time being here. 8-6 with 5:59 left in the opening quarter.
Yeah, Mancino actually hadn't hit a three-pointer in Wilfrid Laurier's first four postseason games. Changed that yesterday with one early against Uquam. And the CKHS now knowing that she indeed is a threat from beyond there.
Zalashak struggled a bit from the free throw line last night. Gets the first tonight to go. Knocks down the second as well. 2-for-2. It's an 8-8 ball game. Just under 6 minutes left here in the first quarter. Here's Hillis crossing over. Vanessa Wesolowski set to check in for the Cougars. Hillis. Now Mancino fakes the three, drives, baseline jump shot off the mark. Offensive rebound put up. That one won't go. And there's Joanna Zalashak grabbing a rebound. Goes behind the back. Crosses over now, then has it taken away. You see some of the risks you run with Joanna Zalashak's flashy style of play. Now a basket in transition the other way. Laurier back in front by two.
Nice speed by Mallory Colmeyer on the fast break. They're outrunning the Cougar defense there. Throwing her up and in for two.
Now it's Carly Graham on the floor getting her first touch. Over to Chamberlain. Inside the three-point line. Back rim. Schmidt with a rebound. Backs her way to the hole now. They're going to call a foul on Hillis. That'll be the team's second and the first on Hillis.
Thought Amber Hillis might have tied that ball up, but call goes to the hometown Cougars.
Could have been traveling as well had that official on the baseline decided to make that call. I don't think anyone in gold would have had an argument there either.
Looks like three out-of-town refs. Sorry, Adams, I interrupt you again. Three out-of-town refs tonight. I don't recognize any of these guys.
And a couple of them are going to chat here. Not sure about what. Just deciding on the number of team fouls in the quarter, as it is two for Laurier. As the Cougars toss in, Dyson shoots it in. Just inside that free throw line.
Gabby Dyson, always the X factor for the Cougars. She's got four. She's already over her total from last night.
Now here's the ball. Short corner for Grant. Looking for a pass. Gets it up top. Hillis tend to shoot. She'll drive. Throw it up. Doesn't get the shot to go. And it's Zalashak. Another rebound. Players all over the floor. Graham, she'll shoot that three in transition. Count it. And Lin Ji and Darius Moeller having a sword fight with those yellow thunder sticks handed out here. Cougar men's basketball players sitting courtside loving their team up three. There's a, I thought it might have been a travel, but it's going to be two shots coming up here for Kimberly Yeldon. Number 12 to the line for two.
Yeldon only played 2 minutes for these Golden Hawks yesterday, making her first two trips to the free throw line this weekend.
First shot is on the money.
Yeldon, a rookie post out of Ottawa, Ontario. 74% free throw shooter for the year.
And both teams continue to knock down from the line here in the first quarter. 13-12 Cougars, 4:14 left to play in the opening 10 minutes.
Doreen Bonsu checks into the game for the first time for Laurier.
Zalashak will go right at her as she brings the ball over the timeline, gets it to Schmidt. 5 for 5 from beyond the arc last night, gets it to Wesolowski. Over to Lettingham, thought about the three, drives, hands off to Zalashak. She'll fade away and come up short. Laurier with a chance to take the lead. Sorry, Britt.
You think Laurier was watching that Cougar game last night? They were all over Danny Schmidt, not giving her an inch out there.
Now it's Grant backing in, gets to the basket and puts it in for two. Golden Hawks controlling the paint early in this game.
Nice little low post move there by Grant, working on Lindsay Lettingham.
Mighty got away with the travel as well on the play. But it's the Golden Hawks back in front. 14-13 now. Wesolowski, count it. Vanessa showing some good control of the body there, Brayden, gives her team a one-point advantage.
Vanessa gave the Cougars some great minutes off the bench yesterday and looking like she's going to continue to do the same tonight.
Grant looking from the elbow. Now gets it up top to Hillish. Hillish to Grant. She'll take it to the basket. Now throw it right to Carly Graham. Turnover. 3 minutes left, opening quarter. Carly Graham almost gave it away. Gets it to Zalashak, though. Baseline jumper is good. 17-14, Cougars. Hillis setting up the offense now for the Golden Hawks. Largest lead of the game right now for the Cougars. In the post, it goes for Grant. Thinks about handing it off. Now that ball squirts out into the hands. Another player down low, kick back out. Hillis has four to shoot. He's going to have to do something with it. Kicks it back, thrown up, and that's going to be a shot clock violation. Good defense for the Cougars. .226 left in the opening quarter. Substitutions on the floor.
Hey, we got a score on that Carlton-St. FX game. It's Carlton 28, St. FX 24 with 7:02 left in the third quarter. That game being played at Carlton.
Here's Wesolowski getting it to Schmidt. Back out Geisen. She's been on fire here to start the game. Couldn't get that one to go. Hit her first two shots. Now it's Laurier back the other way with 2 minutes left in the first quarter. Near side, it's Chaput. Coming off a screen. Well done by the Cougars to trap her. Chaput gets the ball into the hands of Yeldon. She'll drive, shoot, and off the side of the backboard, but a foul on the play. Two free throws coming up for the first-year history major, Kimberly Yeldon. Pardon me, first-year kinesiology major. First free throw is on the money. I don't think either of these teams have missed a free throw yet, Braden.
No, you're right. Cougars 2 for 2, thanks to Joanna Zalashak. Oh, Adamczyk did miss one for Laurier earlier this quarter.
And of course, as we say that, the next one is off the mark, but it will stay with the Golden Hawks. Out of bounds off the Cougars on the rebound. So a fresh shot clock. And a chance to potentially tie with a two-point basket here for Laurier, down 17-15. Inbound is off a foot. We'll try it again. And on the second attempt here, Coach Taylor for the Cougars is going to bring Lindsay Lettingham back in. Wesolowski goes off after a solid couple of minutes on the floor. Inbound comes in. Up top now to Grant. Thinks about a pass into the paint. Now gets it over here to Adamczyk. She'll drive, send it off the glass, then off the rim. Who's going to grab the rebound? It's Geisen for the Cougars. Oh, she'll take it right up to the three-point line. Shoot and send that one off the back of the rim. Gabby now 0 for 2 after hitting her first two shots of the game. There's Mazarol back on the floor after spending some time on the bench. Now a shot put up and two more free throws coming up here for Megan Grant.
Nice little pass there by Mazarol to find Megan Grant down low. Grant did not attempt any free throws yesterday. She did have 14 rebounds.
Foul was the first on Megan Chamberlain. The Cougars now in the penalty with 5. Three players on the floor with one foul. You've got Geisen, Schmidt, and now Chamberlain with one. And it's a tie, pardon me, a one-point Cougar lead, 17-16. 108 left, first quarter. Here's Alishek, stopping, spinning. Nice pass in the paint to Chamberlain. Bounce pass by Zalashak, picks up another assist. The Cougars are up three.
Megan Chamberlain really stepped it up for the Cougars yesterday. Looks like she's going to keep doing the same tonight. Adam Chamberlain up to 4 points on the night.
Now Mazarol into the paint. Has it knocked away, gets it back. Mancino thought about the three, now steps in for a contested two. It's tipped away, and Chamberlain is fouled on the rebound.
That foul will go on number nine, Bree Chaput.
Just the third team foul. So no free throws for the Cougars with 41 seconds left in the first quarter.
Kohlmeyer now coming back into the game for Laurier. Carly Graham checks back in for the Cougars. Carly's going to play a little point here, Adam.
And she'll bring it over the timeline. Carly has knocked down her 1 3-point attempt. Now it's Gabby. She's 0 for 2 from back there. Threw that one away. Lettingham tries to recover. Players all over the place, and it's out of bounds off Laurier. There was no reset on the shot clock, so 9 to shoot for the Cougars.
25.9 left on the game clock here in the first period.
Carly Graham will toss in and get it to Schmidt. Don't leave her open after last night. Geisen in the paint. Chamberlain. Oh, the Cougars had that one drawn up nicely, but the pass from Lettingham was off the mark. Final shot coming up here for Laurier. A 2-point basket would send us back to square one. 19-17 Cougars down to 6 seconds left. Mancino thinking three. That's a high arcing air ball. And the rebound picked up, thrown up by Grant. Had a good look, but could not convert. And we'll head to the second quarter with the Cougars leading 19-17.
Really was kind of a rainmaker for Mancino there. Right from the point of release, you can see that was going to fall well short. Laurier still got a good opportunity there. But the layup attempt by Amy Grant fell, rimmed it out.
Even with that air ball three-pointer, Mancino showing what she can do against these Cougars, leading all players, I believe, with the 5 points.
Yeah, Mancino does have 5 points. That leads all players. Mallory Kohlmeyer has 4 for Laurier. Kimberly Yeldon and Megan Grant both have 3, and Renata Adamczyk has the other for Laurier. 3 players of 4 points for the Cougars: Joanna Zalashak, Gabby Geisen, and Megan Chamberlain. Carly Graham has 3, Vanessa Wazalski has 2, and Lindsay Lettingham has the other 2. Kind of a balanced attack for the Cougars so far. No one with more than 2 buckets.
Of course, with so much on the line tonight, basically a spot in the CIS Final 8 on the line next weekend. Both teams pretty close here so far.
Hamster balls out as part of the halftime entertainment.
The hamster balls?
The big 7 foot tall air filled balls. Put 2 guys and have a race around the court.
Who are the lucky 2? Do we know the lucky 2 gentlemen?
We don't know the lucky 2.
Lynn G and Darius Moll.
Sure, the U of R men's basketball guys would love that. I actually got to try it out on Thursday. I just about passed out from lack of air. I was running around in it for too long.
All right. Looking forward to that. The camera gets left on in the half here on SSN Canada, so stay tuned. After 10 minutes here on the floor, it's 19-17 Cougars. And I believe it'll be Laurier basketball to start. Indeed it will. Right in front of us here, courtside at the Center for Kinesiology, Health, and Sport. Hope you're enjoying your Saturday night. Heck of a basketball game here so far. 2-point Cougar lead.
Megan Grant inbound for Wilfrid Laurier, the fifth year post out of Thunder Bay, Ontario.
And it's Mazarol with it. Held scoreless in the first quarter after leading the team yesterday with 17. And there's a ball in the corner, comes down in the post, double team there. Grant almost threw it away, comes back up to Mancino. Thinks better of the three this time, now has only 2 to shoot, throws one up, and hits!
Nice play by. Had to get around the outstretched arms. Joanna Zalashak was able to correct herself and throw in that long 2-pointer. She really does have a diverse set of abilities, this Mancino, Adam.
Well, she's been held mostly to the outside in this game. We thought she would be a force down low, but the long-range jump shot, with the exception of that air ball, has been falling so far for Mancino. Now Schmidt throws it away. The Cougars turn it over.
Pass intended for Megan Chamberlain. Megan Grant did a nice job of getting in the way of that pass.
There's a drive. There's a shot. There's a baseline jumper that's off the mark. Rebound to Carly Graham. Carly looking for a pass. Gets it up here to Schmidt. Carly and Joanna Zalashak on the floor right now. Joanna gets the ball. Comes off a screen, goes baseline, finds a nice feed to Schmidt, who puts it in for two.
Cougars are finishing tonight, Adam. They're 9 for 16. That's over 50% from the field so far.
Haven't turned the ball over all that much either, just the five. Sound fundamental basketball so far for the Cougars. Playing well defensively, too, holding Laurier to 19. There's a rebound, but a jump ball.
Yeah, and Laurier's done a good job taking care of the basketball, too, Adam. Just three turnovers. Laurier's problem has been their shooting. He's 26% from the field through the first 12 minutes of this contest.
Cougars will take possession, so switch the arrow. Next tie-up or the second half inbound will belong to Laurier. Here's Chamberlain looking for a pass. Goes in the post. Lettingham has to stretch to find it, but gets back in the paint. Up and under. Wow. Lettingham finds a way to get that one, and it's a four-point game.
That's two nice finishes for Lettingham already today, Adam. Lettingham's only got four. No Cougar has more than four. And the Cougars finally have a four-point lead.
Here's the ball in the paint. Spinning a shot off the mark. Chamberlain knocks that rebound out of bounds. And they'll stay right here with Laurier. A fresh 24 to shoot. Kohlmeier set to inbound underneath the Cougar basket. Gets it into Mazarol. Fresh shot clock. They've got plenty of time. Now Kohlmeier way up front here. There's a three-point shot put way off the mark. Following her rebound, though, give her credit. That's Adamczyk. Kicks it out. Gets a second look. Kohlmeier does not miss. Now you can't say enough about the effort from Adamczyk. She knew that shot was going to be off the mark. Followed her shot. Now it's Mazarol almost stealing that one away. One-point Cougar lead. Zalashak will drive. She'll fade away. Throw it up. Off the mark. And Mancino almost steals that rebound away from Mazarol. Now hands it off.
Laurier did a nice job of collapsing on the defensive glass there. Any number of four Golden Hawks could have come down with that one.
And they've got a chance after falling behind by four to take the lead on this trip. There's a step in by Mancino. And you can count it for two. Timeout. Cougars. And a quick 5-0 run. Braden has Laurier in front, 24-23.
Yeah, this game's looking good so far, Adam. Up and down. Ebb and flow.
Ebb and flow, that's a good one. It's been a roller coaster, no doubt. But for the most part, Braden, both teams playing sound basketball. That's what you want to see in a championship-type game like this.
Yeah, plenty on the line for both teams. I don't know if Wilfrid Laurier has the safety net that the Cougars might have given the possibility of the at-large berth.
What are we thinking, or what's the estimation of that percentage that the Cougars would get the at-large bid if they don't win tonight?
I think it really depends on what's going on in that Carlton-St. FX game. And I wasn't a math major, so I can't really figure out all the priorities they used to figure out that wild card berth.
While you're talking about bubble teams and bracketology and all that other stuff, if you're an NCAA basketball fan this weekend, of course, with Selection Sunday coming up tomorrow, but we got our own March Madness north of the border right now. The Cougars can do themselves a favor and just win this game, but right now, down 24-23, Laurier has shown up to play.
Yeah, the Cougars are definitely Carlton fans right now, and Carlton are Cougar fans.
All right. Hopefully that makes sense. Not sure it does to either of us, but like we said, the Cougars can just do themselves a favor to win this one and make it simple for the selection committee. There's a shot by Chamberlain to knock it in. 25-24, Cougars. 6:40 left, second quarter. There's Kohlmeier. Mancino up top to Adamczyk. Pass down low, 6 seconds to shoot. There's a drive, there's a shot, and a foul on the miss. Chamberlain sends her 12 counterpart, Kimberly Yeldon, to the free throw line.
Yeldon seeing a lot of minutes for Laurier here after not really playing at all yesterday. As we mentioned earlier, just 2 minutes on the floor for Yeldon yesterday.
And she has been money from the free throw line. Hits the first. Tied up at 25. The second is good as well. 26-25. Laurier and Kayla Hanna. I don't think she made an appearance on the floor yesterday, Braden, but we'll get a chance in this championship game as she comes in for the Cougars.
Yeah, it's the first time we've seen her this weekend, Adam.
She's going to get a touch on the first possession. Gets it down low to Schmidt. Kicks it out. Carly Graham thinks about the three. Salishak, eight to shoot. She'll come off the screen. Then recover. Pick up that loose ball. Four to shoot. Spins. Fires. And way off the mark. Picked up by Laurier. Tough possession there for the Cougars.
Tough possession by the Cougars. A nice defense by Laurier to really limit the opportunities they had there.
And another foul on the plate and another trip to the free throw line for Kimberly Yeldon. Laurier really working that short corner down on the baseline to perfection, really, creating opportunities down in the paint. This game, Braden, a lot of times we see it in this gym, one team or the other taking a double-digit lead in the first half before, you know, one team or the other makes their comeback, but the largest lead in this game has been four. Missed free throw there by Yeldon. Her team's up one right now.
Yeldon 5-for-7 from the line tonight.
And she hits the second, so it is a two-point game as the airtight contest here between Laurier and Regina continues. 5:40 left, second quarter. Here's Carly Graham, 1-for-1 on the night. Nice entry pass, though, to Kayla Hanna. Couldn't have put that in a better spot. We're tied up at 27. Kayla Hanna making instant impact off the bench, a player that does not often get many minutes. Here's Mancino. Now Hanna playing tight defense there. Forces an awful shot. Offensive rebound, though. That one won't go. Another offensive board. And how about the play here for Yeldon taking over for the Golden Hawks?
Yeldon hit the floor hard, but not before she came up with a tough rebound for Laurier. She's looked impressive for these Golden Hawks.
Nice drive there by Kohlmeyer. All started, though, by Yeldon. Now she needs a sub as she is gassed. Makes me wonder why we didn't see her much yesterday, Braden. Ball goes in the post for Graham, and she will be, pardon me, for Hanna, and she will be fouled.
Foul should be on Yeldon here, I think. And it is. That's her first.
First team foul as well here in the quarter. Neither team really in any sort of foul trouble. Neither team has any player with two fouls, just the one. Here's Carly Graham off the inbound. Thought about a deep one. 10 seconds to shoot. Cougars down two. Gabby, she's 0-for-2 from back there. And what do we have? A foul away from the ball. This will be number 15 in purple, Megan Grant. So her first. A part of me, number 11, Bonsu. So two team fouls now on either squad. Inbound comes to Zalishak. Nice find by Carly Graham, who all of a sudden, Brady, has turned into a playmaker. Free throws coming up for Zalishak.
Well, she's kind of had to turn into a playmaker, Adam. They're covering her so tight on the perimeter where she could be so dangerous.
Zalishak rips the first. Joanna with 5 points. Through about 15 minutes in the first half.
5 points today. Make that. Oh, keep that at 5 points.
Lettingham, though, wide open for the rebound, puts it in. Cougars go up one.
What I was getting at before Lettingham rudely interrupted me, Zalishak crushed her career high with 17 rebounds yesterday. She's all over the glass.
Yeah, there's a shot from Kohlmeyer from beyond the arc. That's long. And Kayla Hanna, who's been solid in a couple of minutes on the floor here, grabs the board. Zalishak crossing over, gets it to Hanna. Oh, she had an open look. Passes off, though, to Gabby. She'll drive. She'll shoot off the heel of the rim. And here come Laurier. 4 minutes left. First half. Open look in the corner. Three ball short. Nice offensive rebound, though, by Grant. Extending with the arm, putting her team back up by one. What a first half. Back and forth we go.
Why is ref Ron Bailey sitting at the scores table? Is he waiting to be subbed in? I don't think I've ever seen that before. He's Ron just hanging out.
Ace Bailey wearing the streeters, yeah. And he's the Regina, one of the most premier, I guess, officials in Regina. Ball's tipped out of bounds, so it'll be Cougar ball underneath the basket.
Adamczyk back into the game for Laurier now.
Danny Schmidt gets it in. Dalvashak, or pardon me, Lettingham, far corner, and has that one knocked away with 4 seconds to shoot for the Cougars.
Mancino comes up with the block there, much to the delight of the Laurier bench, who are off their feet clapping after that defensive stop.
Dalvashak gets it in now. 2 seconds to shoot, and the Cougars are going to take too long to get this one up. Great possession defensively for Laurier. They still hold on to this one-point lead. 3:26 left in the first half. Adam Geiger and Braden Conchu here on SSN Canada. Regional championship Saturday all across the country. The Cougars and the Golden Hawks looking for a spot in the CIS National Tournament next weekend. Baseline knocked away. Picked right back up by Adamczyk. They have 6 to shoot now. Do the Golden Hawks fade away. Kohlmeier gets it to go in traffic.
Mallory Kohlmeier with a nice play there. Showing some range on the little fadeaway.
Puts her team up 33-30. Gabby looking for the answer and finds it. Just seems like this game is destined to go right down to the wire break. Neither team is willing to give an inch.
I'll bet Gabby Geisen has practiced that shot from the elbow 5,000 times during her career here at the U of R, Adam.
There's a backdoor cut. What a find by Grant. And it's Adamczyk putting it in.
Nice,
easy too.
Nice play drawn up by Laurier there. These teams are looking impressive right now. Adam, it's looking like a regional championship.
Sometimes you worry about nerves and performance in a game like this. Both teams showing up as Lettingham gets clobbered and is shaking up the cobwebs right now. She's going to shoot too. Or is she? I'm going to say that ball was on the floor. Just the fourth team foul on Laurier.
Lettingham still with 3 little canaries flying around her head right now. She's okay.
Gets the inbounds pass and tosses it back to Zalashak. 12 to shoot. Now it's Gabby looking for the tie. Count it. Gabby's having a first half.
Give her 9 points, Adam. Seems like she's had more.
35-35. Impressive first half from both teams here at the CKHS. And that ball's going to find the baseline. That turnover, Braden. One of very few in this first half for both teams.
Yeah, that's just Wilfrid Laurier's 4th of the game. Cougars just with 6. Cougars still shooting 56% right now.
Lindsay Lettingham on the bench getting looked at by Dave Taylor and team trainer as well. Looks a little bit woozy. Hopefully we'll get back or her back on the floor. We'll keep an eye on that. Here's Zalashak. Now spinning. Zalashak looks for a bounce pass. It's stolen away. That would be bad news for the Cougars if Zalashak were unable to return. And a travel call here. Lynn G letting Kohlmeier here for Wilfrid Laurier know that she walked. 1:37 left in the first half. It's a tie basketball game.
We thought we'd seen the last of Lynn G's sideline antics here at the CKHS.
He's even got the white towel hung over his shoulder. He's like Linus. He carries that thing everywhere. Here's Wesolowski. There's Gabby Geisen. She's got 9. Wesolowski with 2, and she walks. Nobody with a white towel on this end of the floor to tell Vanessa, but the official with the whistle gives the ball to to Laurier. 1:22 left. First half. Tie basketball game, 35-35. Here's Grant. Here's Mazzaro, open for 3. It's her first shot of the game, I believe, and she knocks it down from beyond the arc. It's a 3-point lead.
Mazzaro 1-for-1 from 3-point land yesterday, now 1-for-1 from 3-point land tonight. And we saw Mazzaro do most of her damage on penetrating, but she can do it on the outside, too.
Sorry, Braden, what a move by Zalashak. Owns that baseline and brings her team within 1. Every game, you're good for about 1 or 2 of those type plays from Zalashak. 10 seconds to shoot, 40 seconds to play in the half. Here's Kohlmeier, baseline jump shot. She rattles that one around. Another offensive rebound, though, picked up. Back out to Kohlmeier for three. Second chance points, killing the Cougars. It's a four-point Golden Hawk lead. Not much of a difference here between shot and game clock, so the Cougars could hold for the final rip. And instead, a foul away from the ball. This is going to go on Laurier, so two free throws coming up for Zalashek.
Yeah, Laurier crashing the offensive glass at him. They've got 12 offensive boards already this game.
Kohlmeier picks up that foul. That's her second. And with two free throws coming up, Laurier wants to draw their 17-second shot up right now. We'll take a timeout and talk it over. As the Cougar crew comes out to fire out some T-shirts.
Yeah, Mallory Kohlmeier up to 14 points already for Laurier Adam. 5 for 10 from the field, 2 for 5 from 3-point line. 2 for 2 from the line. Kimberly Yeldon, 6 points and 5 rebounds for Wilfrid Laurier. Yeldon with 11 minutes played after only playing 2 last night. Krista Mancino with 9 points for Laurier. For the Cougars, it's Gabby Geisen. She's got 9. Joanna Zalashak has 7, Megan Chamberlain has 6, and Lynn Lettingham has 6, but we haven't seen her since she got knocked in the head about 3 minutes ago. She's probably going to sit out this rest of the half on the bench and see where she's at after halftime.
Lindsay will indeed take a seat again next to the team trainer and head coach Dave Taylor on the far end of the bench.
Out-of-town scoreboard has St. FX now up 46-39 on Carlton. There's 6:33 left in the fourth quarter there.
Zalashak to the free throw line. 17 seconds left to play in the first half. Zalashak off on the first. Well, it looks like the Cougars will find themselves trailing at the half again. It's worked out for them on many occasions this year, but how many times do you want to go to the well? They're down 3. It's Laurier with the basketball. If they can get it over the timeline, they'll have a chance for the last shot, and they will. On the board for the first time, it's Laura Doyle, so look out for her. She might be one of those three-point specialists. 3 seconds left. Goes to the far corner. Shot put up by Adamczyk, way off the mark. And the Cougars will watch that one hit the floor as the first half buzzer sounds. 41-38, Laurier Braden at the half. And it's been a beauty. We'll take a break for 15 minutes or so and come back for what should be a barn burner of a second half. 41-38 Laurier with a spot in the CIS Nationals on the line here on SSN Canada.
stuff will kill you.
All right, welcome back to the Center for Kinesiology, Health, and Sport. 20 minutes are in the books, and if the next 20 are as near as good as the first ones were, then we're in for a heck of a finish. 41-38, Laurier at the half. Braden has some numbers.
That's been the Mallory Kohlmeyer show so far for the Golden Hawks. 5-for-10 from the field, 2-for-5 from the three-point land, 2-for-2 from the free-throw line. She's got 14 points to lead all players. Krista Mancino has 9 points for the Golden Hawks. Kimberly Yeldon and Megan Grant both have 6. For the Cougars, Joe Zalashak has 8 points. Gabby Geisen has a team-high 9. And Megan Chamberlain and Lindsay Lettingham both have 6 points. About 20 seconds away from inbound pass start the second half here.
And it'll be the Golden Hawks. 2 toss in just in front of us here at the scorer's table. 20 minutes separating one of these two teams from the CIS National Championships. And we're underway here in the second half. It's Laurier to start. Quick shot, quick release from Adamczyk. Can't hit. Rebound tapped out off of Laurier. And it's good to see Braden Lindsay Lettingham back on the floor.
Yeah, Lettingham knocked a little woozy by a shot to the head there late in the second half. Late in the second quarter. Looks like she's going to be all right, though.
Has the cobwebs shaken out, and she's going to have the ball right here. First touch offensively for the Cougars in the third quarter. Goes over to Danny Schmidt. She exploded in the second half yesterday. Hasn't really got into it in this one. Crossover dribble by Zalashak. She'll throw a pass to the paint, knocked away. Here comes Mazarol. 2-on-1. She'll stop in transition and hit. Largest lead of the game. It's 5, 43-38 Laurier.
Mazarol with 5 points now for Laurier. Cougars have to watch out. If she catches fire like she did yesterday, they might be in trouble.
9:14 left in the third quarter. And a turnover as Laurier steals it away. They'll bring it back into the front court.
Out-of-town scoreboard says St. Effect 62, Carlton 57 with 50 seconds left in the fourth quarter there. Down to the wire with St. Effect maybe coming close to pulling it off.
That would be bad news for the Cougars.
That would be bad news for the Cougars.
3-point jump shot up and off the mark. Mancino can't hit. Now it's Zalashak to the front court. Geisen into the paint. Schmidt driving, and she will head to the line for 2. And look out, Mazarol.
Mazarol takes out 2 advertising barriers, much like the guy in the hamster ball did at halftime.
Yeah, I don't know if any. Those hamster balls were hilarious. And it's Danny Schmidt to the line for 2. Hits the first.
Danny Schmidt, of course, had a career-high 23 points yesterday. A perfect 5-for-5 from three-point land. She never had more than 2 three-pointers in the game up until last night's game against Victoria.
Mazarol scoops up the inbounds after a 2-for-2 trip. 43-40. Laurier with possession now. Comes back to Mazarol. Here's Mancino. Near wing. Up top, Adamczyk. She'll drive. She'll shoot. And tough shot off the mark. Gets her own rebound, though, on the tip.
Megan Grant with a nice play down low for Laurier. She's been a handful for the Cougars. She had 14 rebounds yesterday. Doing good on the glass for the Golden Hawks again tonight.
Here's Kohlmeyer. Had a great first half. Looking to continue that. Why not? Knocks it down for 3. Kohlmeyer with 17 points. It's a 6-point Golden Hawk lead.
Kohlmeyer now 3-for-6 from three-point land.
Chamberlain, Lettingham, easy 2. Good work down in the post. 46-42. Cougars still down 4. Here's Mazarol. Now up top, Adamczyk almost threw it away, but heads up play, goes back and gets it. 6 seconds to shoot here for Laurier, driving. Mazarol kicks it back down to 3. Drive, and a basket counted, plus the foul. Mallory Kohlmeyer going off her 5th year biology major. She is looking to keep this season alive for the Golden Hawks.
Kohlmeyer now with 19 points, looking to make it 20 with a free throw here.
Looking to add to the largest lead of the game at 6. And she is, and Fuego make it 7 now, 49-42.
Kohlmeyer matches her season high in points. She also had 20 against Waterloo on February 16th. Career high is 31 set last year as the Cougars turn the ball over again.
Geisen can't control it. Now here comes Laurier back into the front court. Now, fadeaway jump shot on that baseline, and she is absolutely scorching. Kohlmeyer with 22. And it's a 9-point Laurier lead, Braden. Everything is seeming to go wrong here for the Cougars, including that out-of-town scoreboard. 7 minutes left in the third quarter. They're down 9.
Mallory Kohlmeyer, we barely noticed her yesterday against UQAM. She was 1-for-6 from the field last night. Only had 3 points. She's got 22 tonight. She's just hitting everything.
Well, the Cougars are going to have to find a way to slow her down. Regina is used to being in this position down in the second half, but usually they're the team that has controlled the momentum in the final 20 minutes. So far, it's been all Laurier extending on a lead. It is up to 9.
Yeah, Laurier outscoring the Cougs 10-4 here in the third quarter, 3 minutes in.
Well, let's see what the Cougars can do out of the timeout.
St. FX up 62-59 on Carleton with 0.9 seconds left in the fourth quarter.
That one pretty much in the books. Bad news for the Cougars in terms of an at-large bid, potentially with a loss here. 51-42. Here's Zalashak to the front court. There's Lettingham. Ball on the floor. She'll drive. She'll put it up and gets the tough roll. Lindsay Lettingham having a great game in this one for the Cougars.
Yeah, Lettingham, first Cougar to double digits. She's got 10 now.
Chamberlain comes out. Kohlmeyer slips to the floor, but gets it off to Mazarol. Her three rips it down. 54-44, 10-point game. Now Zalashak. Joanna back to Carly Graham. She'll drive and travel before the basket. So wave it off. Laurier basketball, they look to add to their 10-point lead.
And St. FX has defeated Carleton in Carleton.
Everything going wrong these last 10 minutes, both in this gym and out of it for the Cougars. And it's been all thanks to this girl, Kohlmeyer, absolutely killing it from the field. Back to Mancino, wide open for three, and Dave Taylor puts his hands on his head and can't believe it. His team's lack of defense there, down by 13. Danny Schmidt, Lettingham, Carly Graham. Schmidt now in the paint. Shot from the free throw line, off the mark. Chamberlain fighting for the rebound. Comes into the lap of Schmidt. She'll put it on the floor, take it to the basket. Now gets trapped and throws it away. 57-44. Cougars down double digits, and it's right now Laurier. They can't miss.
Laurier outscoring the Cougars 16-6 now in the third quarter here.
Mancino. That one almost dropped. Offensive rebound drops right to Grant. Now Mazarol. She'll cross over on Zalashak, who's used to doing that to other players. But it's Schmidt now stealing it away, then losing her footing. And it's picked up by Laurier. Everything that could go wrong, Braden, is for the Cougars.
Cougars shooting 58% from the game and losing by 13.
Figure that one out.
These numbers don't add up.
What's Laurier shooting in the second half? I don't think they've missed. There's a ball out of bounds. It'll stay with the Golden Hawks. 10 to shoot. 4:38 to play in the worst third quarter imaginable here for the Cougars. Down 13 points. Inbounds. Kohlmeyer finally misses a shot. And ooh, Cougars almost had that one go out of bounds off them, but we'll say it is Regina basketball. Bonsu back in the game for the Golden Hawks. Zalashak into the front court. Now to Lettingham. 13 seconds to shoot. Chamberlain has to shovel that one off to Schmidt. Working on Bonsu. Back to Chamberlain. She'll think baseline. Now traveling called on Megan Chamberlain. Good 57-44. The Cougars have been stuck on 44 for a while now, and Gabby Geisen, who had a pretty good first half, is going to come on the floor.
Laurier on an 11-2 run right now. Not over the last 3 minutes.
Mazarol, first-year player running the point for a team right now that is 14 minutes away from the CIS Nationals. Mancino, wide open. Cougars catch a break with her not taking the shot. Now a travel called on Kohlmeier.
Maybe a non-travel on one end of the floor, match with a non-travel on the other, perhaps. Consistency is key.
Zalashak for the Cougars. They have been anything but consistent in this third quarter. Meanwhile, Laurier is shooting the lights out. Lettingham, frustrated, wants someone to move. She'll take it herself and counted plus the foul. Lindsay Lettingham taking over. Still down 11, but a flicker of hope there for the Cougars.
Yeah, Lettingham did that. That was still a broken play on the offensive side of the ball for the Cougars. Not what they had drawn up. I'm so negative, Adam.
You're right, though. As much as it was a nice basket and just a two-point play, it was created off a broken play, and the Cougars going to have to figure it out offensively. 3:37 left, third quarter. Mancino again left wide open, and she hits. Dave Taylor wants Megan Chamberlain back on the floor. That's a big hit, 14-point game.
Mancino, not a girl you can leave open on the perimeter, and they've done that consistently here in this third quarter.
Wazalowski short on the layup. Didn't find herself in a great position there. Laurier is absolutely stunning this crowd. They've got the Cougars back on their heels, to say the least. Another open player. She steps in and shoots the two. Man, the Cougars are just opening the door for Laurier, allowing them to walk right into a potential CIS National Championship.
Now a 16-point lead for Laurier. 62-46 here, 3 minutes left in the third quarter.
Carly Graham is going to try to stop the bleeding. Counted for three. Remember that shot, Braden, if the Cougars are able to come back. Carly Graham stops what was an awful run for Cougars fans, for Laurier. Absolutely beautiful. Mancino almost loses it. Now it's Mazarol. 10 to shoot. 2:30 to play in the third quarter. Here's Mazarol crossing over, finding it. Looking like Joanna Zalashak for the Cougars. It's Mazarol dishing out a beauty, 2 points.
And Kimberly Yeldon finishing off for Laurier.
Now it's Joanna for Regina. Over here to Lindsay Lettingham, putting the ball on the floor. Wazalowski fakes, drives, can't get the layup to go. 2 minutes left, third quarter. 15-point game. Bonsu. Far corner. All the way across, Mazarol. Looking for a teammate. Gets it up top. That's a perfect teammate to find in this quarter. Now down low to Mancino, and the shot's off the mark.
Finally, Laurier misses at him.
Well, the Cougars finally played some defense on that possession. Here's Joanna now looking to play some offense off the window. Can hit. The Cougars absolutely stone cold from the field.
I wish I had the team stats just for this quarter, Adam.
Not going to be pretty for the Cougars, tell you that much. 1:20 left. Mancino finally has someone in her face out there in that three-point line. Mazarol, though, didn't have much of a challenge. Now drives. Mancino is fouled. Two free throws on the way. Body language says a lot, Braden. Right now, the Cougars look like a defeated bunch with 11 minutes left in this game, and Laurier is looking like a team that just can't be beat.
Laurier is looking like a team that's going to Windsor right now, Adam.
Which wouldn't be that far away from where they call home.
Probably not compared to Regina, anyway.
Mancino good on the free throw. 16-point game. Credit Laurier after Carly Graham hit that three-point jump shot. It looked like the Cougars maybe were set to go on a little bit of run of their own, but Laurier has scored the game's last 5 points, I believe, now to lead by 17. Here's Joanna. Take breaking down on 1 minute left in the third quarter. Chamberlain to the post for Lettingham. She gets bumped, goes up, and it's Lindsay heating up for the Cougars.
Lettingham up to 14 now for the Cougs.
Mazarol. Cougars got to step up defensively here and shut it down in the last 60 seconds of the quarter. Almost forced a turnover. Now it's Kohlmeier. 40 seconds to play. She'll drive. She'll throw it up. And, hey, when it's your night, it's your night. Kohlmeier absolutely killing it with 24. Here's Chamberlain with 25 seconds to play. Third quarter. Carly Grand, they could use a big shot from her, but she picks up that dribble. Now Schmidt, she'll take it in and connect.
Nice play by Schmidt. Might have gotten away with a little bit of a travel there as Laurier's coach was yelling for it.
Last shot of the quarter. They can hold for it here with 7 seconds left in the third. It's Mazarol. Driving, almost lost it. Gets it back. Kohlmeier will take the last shot and almost got the generous roll, but make or no make on that final shot. It's a big lead after three. 68-53, Braden. The Cougars in a big hole heading to the final 10 minutes.
Yeah, Mallory Kohlmeier, what can you say, Adam? 9 for 16 from the field now. She's got 24 points. Krista Mancino, not really all that far behind her from Wilfrid Laurier. She's 6 for 13 from the field. 3 for 5 from three-point land, and the Cougars keep leaving her wide open up top on the perimeter. Their Mancino's got 17. Kimberly Yeldon now has 10 points for Laurier to go along with her 7 rebounds. Cougars were outscored 27-15 in a third quarter that's really all season long belonged to them.
And with that safety net now apparently gone, after such a remarkable regular season, Braden, the Cougars now have 10 minutes left to basically save their season. Is that accurate? Are we looking at win or go home here, you think?
I'm not really sure whether the wild card to go to Carleton or Regina or even another team that we're not talking about right now. There's too many permeations in that wild card formula for me to figure out now, but I can't imagine that State FX win has helped those chances any, should Laurier go on and take this game here.
Well, the Cougars are going to have to play like it's win or go home here if they want any chance of coming back in this one. The Cougar bench just got word, Braden, that St. FX won that game. And
Dave Taylor now knows the St. FX won.
I think you had a little bit of something to do with that. Flash the thumbs down across the court. So the Cougars know, at least head coach Dave Taylor knows, they need to win this game, and there's a good start. Dalashak off the window and in.
Adam, if they're going to win this game, they're going to have to do it on the defensive side of the ball.
There we go. 13 points the deficit. This gym is just waiting for a reason to get into this second half. Third quarter didn't help. There's the pass between the legs. Are you kidding me? Laurier not stepping back. What a pass there from Mazarol. Not sure who got the basket break, but it was a beauty. Carly Graham now for the Cougars. Up top, Schmidt. And she walked. No doubt about that one. Turnover by the Cougars.
Still can't get over the pass by Mazarol between the legs of Megan Chamberlain.
Between the legs and then three or four other players in the area that didn't get a piece of the ball. Just a fancy little threading of the needle there by Mazarol. We talked to her post-game after the win last night. This thing keeps up. We're going to talk to her again. She thrives. Kicks. Shot goes up. Shot goes down. Kimberly Yeldon. It's a 17-point lead. That was Shaq now. Crossing over, spinning. She'll try to do it herself. Gets it out to Schmidt. Hey, she was doing this yesterday, but something's just not right in Cougar land tonight.
Cougars have lost just once on the home floor. That was to Saskatchewan back on February 10th.
And even that game, they were real close down the stretch.
67-66 was the score in that game.
This one has not been close. First half was brilliant, but this second half has been an absolute nightmare for the Cougars. Timeout, down 17, 72-55.
Who saw this coming?
Not me. Not anybody, I don't think.
Laurier came out of that dressing room a different team here in this second half. Hitting everything, making nice plays on the defensive side of the ball.
Sometimes I think it just comes down to it's your night. And tonight it is, you go up and down the Laurier roster, and it's their night for Kohlmeier, for Mancino having a beauty, Mazarol as well. You look up at the score sheet, 24 points for Kohlmeier to lead the way. Braden's got some more.
Yeah, Kohlmeier with 24, Mancino still with 17, Yeldon with 14. Mazarol, the rookie guard from Elliott Lake, Ontario, she's got 5 assists.
A few former Cougar players in attendance, Carmen Stewart and a few others. Maybe they can get them on the floor for the Cougars. They need a lot of help right now, down 17.
It's a gloomy-looking bunch there on the Cougar bench, Adam, for good reason. And lots of smiles in purple.
For good reason. They've got the basketball and a 17-point lead. Far corner, it's Kohlmeier. Lindsay Lettingham is all over her. They've got to be in this fourth quarter if they want any chance. But a late in the shot clock foul picked up here by Megan Chamberlain, and she can't believe it. Hands on the hips.
Chamberlain, we whistled for her third foul.
Second team foul on the Cougars in the quarter. Still 8:27 to play in the final 10 minutes, but time is already an enemy of the Cougars. Down 17. There's a shot forced up by Adams that got a piece of the rim, tipped out, and will Hillis get there? No. Out of bounds, Cougar ball.
Bodies flying everywhere in that last rebound. Zalashak went crashing into about three people, sent them flying.
At this rate, the Cougars are going to have to make up about 2 points per minute.
Make up, not just score.
Well, there's a good start. Carly Graham for two. 15-point game. Yeah, even scoring 2 points a minute has been a problem for the Cougars right now. Not so much for Laurier. It's Kohlmeier to the post. Back out. Open look. Good job of closing, though, by Zalashak. Forces a bad shot. Now rebound picked up. Lettingham gets it off to Zalashak, and a jump ball called. Possession favoring Laurier. Finally, some effort, some intensity from the Cougars, though.
Yeah, Lettingham and Zalashak both crash into the floor there. Zalashak tried to rip the ball out of the Damsik's hands to no avail. Damsik has been kind of quiet all weekend. Had 12, that's under a season average yesterday. Only has 3 tonight. But really, she hasn't been needed with the way her other teammates have stepped up.
14 seconds to shoot. Here's Hillis. Wraps it down into the post. Ed Amsick throws it up. Off the mark. Cougars get a rebound. Lettingham turns and sees that ball heading right for. Picks it up. In transition. Quick shot and she knocks it down. 13-point game. Dave Taylor's out of his mind on that sideline. Wants his team to press. They don't get the message. Now they do. And Joanna's going to pick up a foul. That'll be the Cougars' third in the quarter. And Dave Taylor irate with his team for basically not following the program.
I think I heard that. I think everyone heard that.
Dave Taylor wants everyone to hear it right now. He wants to make sure his team gets the message. They're down 13. Hillis. Oh, I don't know about that. Foul called on Zalashak. That'll be the fourth team foul.
She just kind of fell over at him. Zalashak was in the vicinity. I don't know if there was any contact there.
She might have tripped over the Laurier player on the far side of the floor. Cougar fans here not liking the fact their team has been whistled 4 times already in the first 3 minutes. Laurier still without a foul.
And even more problematic, that's now 4 fouls on Zalashak.
You got to leave her out there, though, down 13. Good defense by the Cougars, though. What a possession, traveling. Well, they're not done yet. 6:46 left. Big three-pointer here, maybe. Cuts it down to 10.
Is it Carly Graham time?
Why not? She had it. Now she gets it back. Ooh, thought about it. Now steps in. Puts it up for 2. Count it. 6-0 run by the Cougars. They're down 11. Lin G finally has reason in this second half to wave the towel. Pressed by the Cougars. Well, Laurier is going to get it over. Things starting to heat up here in the CKHS.
It's weird to see a Dave Taylor coach team press at him.
Offensive foul called on Zal, or pardon me, on the Golden Hawks. and the Cougars have a chance to cut it to single digits with a basket. That was a dangerous play there, Braden, if Zalashak picks up that fifth.
That was gutsy.
You've got to think in the back of their minds that the officials knew they might have owned one to the Cougars there. Here's Zalashak off a screen, kicking it out. Oh, I thought it was going up. Would have been a big shot. Still 10 to shoot for the Cougars. Zalashak will take it in, kick it out. Carly Graham, 6 to shoot. Late in the shot clock, puts it off the window. That's short. And picked up by Laurier. Mazarol with 5:48 to play. Cougar fans making noise. They got the Thunder Sticks. They want a solid defensive possession here. Mazarol looking for other ideas. Puts it down low. Off the mark. Rebound on the floor. Tip back out. Mazarol drives. Mazarol kicks. Quick hand by Schmidt to knock it away. Now she almost steals it. Comes back to Kohlmeier.
Cougars finally showing some intensity on the defensive side of the ball, Adam.
And credit the fans for staying vocal throughout this extended possession. 7 to shoot. Mazarol drives on the floor. Ball's knocked away. Stolen by Chamberlain. She gets it to Lettingham. They're into it, that's for sure. Can the Cougars build off of it? Joanna looking for a pass. They got to settle down. Play like they're the only ones in the gym right now. Here's Alice Shack in the post, going up, trying to draw the foul. Gets her own rebound. Well, they were going to count that if it dropped, but it'll be 2 free throws.
That would have been a generous continuation there. And he was waiting to see if that dropped too.
Joanna has not been great from the free throw line this year, but she'll have two of the biggest ones of the season coming up right now.
Zalashak 4-for-6 from the line today. She was 5-for-10 yesterday.
Nothing but nylon.
Think Brittany Reed wants in this game?
She would love to be in this game, and the Cougars would love to have her. Offensive rebound not there. It's a 10-point game with 5 minutes left. Fourth quarter. Half-court defense for the Cougars. Laurier has gone a little bit cold in this fourth quarter, giving Regina a chance to get back in it. It's more so the Cougar defense has stepped it up. Kohlmeier with 6 to shoot. Now they look frustrated now. Mancino out of bounds with 2 to shoot. Another great possession for the Cougars defensively, but 2 seconds still to go.
Nice play by Lettingham late in the shot clock to knock that ball off Mancino and out of bounds. Going to have to be a quick shot here for Laurier.
And a five-second violation. It's incredible how this crowd has turned this game around. Now it's Laurier looking lost, but have the Cougars dug themselves too big a hole with 4:29 left. 72-62. Sorry, Braden.
I got nothing.
Here's Zalashak. She's got a wide-open lane. Kicks it out. Biggest shot of the night for the Cougars. Oh, that was halfway down and came out. Everybody in the gym wanting that one to fall. Here's Mazarol. This would be a big bucket to break the Cougars' backs if this one drops. But it's off the mark, out of bounds. Still life for Regina. 4:05 left, fourth quarter. They're down 10. Let's not kid ourselves, Brayton. Still a big mountain to climb.
Megan Grant with 1 3-pointer hit in her career. Probably not the shot you want her taking in this situation. The crowd's going to let her hear about it now.
She's no Chelsea Cassano. Here's Lindsay Lettingham. Cougars need a big shot. There's Chamberlain. Big mismatch down low. 8-point game. I'm out, Laurier. 72-64. Having fun, Braden?
Heart's starting to beat a little bit, Adam. Along with everyone else here at the CKHS, Cougars now outscoring Wilfrid Laurier 11-4 here in this fourth quarter. Taylor's just got to calm everyone down here in this timeout now.
I find it hilarious. Shot in the face with that shirt, first of all. Second of all, I mean, this game has embodied this season and magnified it so much more. The Cougars are a team that has seemingly game in and game out at the CKHS, fallen behind and then come back. Have they fallen behind too much in this game? Down by 17 at one point. They're trying their best. Down 8 now. This would be one of many comebacks on the year, but by far the biggest in the biggest stage.
It would be a comeback of epic proportions, but Adam, there's still a ton of work left to do against a very, very good Wilfrid Laurier team. 72-64 here for the Golden Hawks. 3:51 left in the fourth quarter.
Nick Panko just gave me the ominous look. He knows we're still in it, but is there hope? One of the Cougar men's assistant basketball coaches. 3:51 left. It's Laurier basketball. You got to think if the Cougars can maybe shut down the Golden Hawks on a couple straight possessions.
Yeah, and no doubt Wilfrid Laurier coach Paul Falco was trying to do the same thing in that timeout. Calm his troops down.
All 10 players on the floor were on this side of the half-court stripe, but Laurier still manages to get it over. 15 to shoot. Kohlmeyer.
Paul Falco's Laurier coach, Shane Falco, the quarterback from the replacements.
Big shot for Mazarol. Back rim. Cougars need the rebound. Oh, they're going to stay out of bounds off the Cougars.
Yeah, Danny Schmidt last touch. Well, that's the right call there. She knew it, too.
3:28 left. A fresh shot clock for Laurier. That's a big break. Cougars unable to get that rebound. Remember, they've got four fouls, too. Can't foul and send him to the line, but they will. That one almost dropped. That would have been real tough.
We should have mentioned Joe Zalashak off the floor for the Cougars. Oh, here she comes back on. Of course, she's saddled with those four fouls.
So Dave Taylor will play offense, defense for the rest of the basically with Zalashak, the best he can anyways. Grant to the line. Needing a couple of big shots. Gets the first.
Grant, a 64% free throw shooter for her career, hitting that big one.
Chance to make it a double-digit game one more time. And will not do it. Rebound picked up by Chamberlain. Give the ball to Carly Graham if you're the Cougars. That's my call. Best three-point shooter on the floor. Instead, it goes into the post. Chamberlain knocked away, gets it back, kicks it out. And it's stolen by Mazarol. Two-on-one, into the paint, kicks, and scores right at Joanna Zalashak.
Nice play by Mazarol to keep her wits about her, throw it up and over Zalashak, and nice touch to get that to go.
Carly from deep! NBA 3, 75-67, 8-point game. Just when you think they're out of it, Braden. Oh, Zalashak. It's pushed off on, no foul, 12 to shoot. Officials hearing it, and then the Cougars pick up a bit of a cheapie away from the basket. Two free throws coming up.
Dave Taylor. About 1,200 people shaking their head here at the CKHS.
But it's by shaking, you head, shaking their head, you mean screaming at the top of their lungs. Well, Mancino has a chance at the line.
Mancino 2-for-2 from the line tonight.
Hey, man, give Laurier credit. They are absolutely responding to all the adversity thrown at them in the fourth quarter here.
Yeah, hitting big free throws. These are big. Laurier 15-for-19 for the game from the charity stripe.
Three ball from deep. That one way off. Zalashak couldn't handle the rebound, but it is out of bounds off Laurier.
Maybe a little bit of optimism there from Carly after hitting that last one from out there.
To be honest, so down 10, those are the kind of shots that are going to have to fall here with 2:19 left. Things are looking next to impossible now for the Cougars, but I guess if any team can erase a 10-point deficit late in the game, it's been these cardiac Cougars. Carly Graham, and she travels. No, she stepped on the line. Either way, it's a turnover. Dangerous times for Regina. Their season on the line. I guess selection Sunday, Northern style, would be tomorrow. They have a chance for that at-large bid with a loss. Mazarol now for the Golden Hawks.
Zalshak's got to watch that.
Oh, we're going to call a block there. Looked like an offensive foul on Chamberlain. That'll be her fourth, and more free throws coming up.
Mazarol to the line now for the first time tonight. She was 3-for-3 yesterday.
First one off the back of the rim. Mazarol teeing up the second. It's true.
Are you allowed to jump shoot as on your free throw?
Yeah, we talked about that last night. I guess so. Schmidt fakes the three, drives, almost lost the ball, now gets it back to Carly. Graham is stuck with it. Now Lettingham drives, and offensive foul, Braden, whistled on Lindsay Lettingham. I don't know. It's a good call. Fans aren't liking it, of course. The Cougars down 11.
That was the right call on that play. I think the fans are more upset about the calls on the other end.
Well, 1:39 left in the fourth quarter. Mazarol going to the free throw line to pretty much ice this game, Braden. I think we're starting to talk now about Laurier against all odds here, coming in and winning two games back-to-back nights. They're going to make a trip to the CIS Nationals. Barring a miracle, really, for the Cougars.
Yeah, a miracle is what it's going to take here. And all credit to Laurier. They've looked like a very good basketball team, Adam.
Free throw off the mark. Zalashak grabs the rebound, down 12 points over the timeline. She'll drive. She'll kick it to Lettingham. Two-point jumper is short. Rebound taken by the Cougars. Here's Carly. Oh, she thought about it. Would have been Jeff Lekomsky range. Oh, Joanna. Gets it to Lindsay.
I think Joanna lost a contact, Adam.
Joanna can't see. She's got a contact in her eye. Throws it to the bench. Now, lost ball. And when you're losing contacts, Braden, in the last minute of a game, everything just going wrong for the Cougars. Carly Graham with a hard foul. It'll be free throws for Laurier. And, well, still 65 seconds left, but I think you can start booking your tickets, Laurier fans, to Windsor for the CIS National Championship.
I don't think they need to book tickets. I think they need to just drive.
You know what I'm talking about, buddy. They need tickets to get in the gym.
Yeah, you don't book them.
Okay. 80-67. I guess there's still a chance that these two teams could be there together.
Yeah, Regina with a chance getting that a large bid. Kohlmeyer now with 25 points tonight for Laurier.
We'll talk to Kohlmeyer and we'll talk to Felicia Mansworld as well. A fifth-year player and a first-year player post-game here for Laurier. The third foul of the quarter called on Laurier on that miss. Well, the Cougars just dug themselves too big a hole. 17 points. They were down, and now head coach Dave Taylor will call a timeout. 56 seconds left in the fourth quarter.
I don't know what you drop if you're head coach Dave Taylor. Does he have a 13-point play in the books?
I doubt it, but...
Yeah, second and third quarters, Wilfrid Laurier just exploded, scored 24 in the second, 27 in the third when they pulled away from the Cougars. Really, the Cougars at one point, I think they had it down to about 9, and that was as close as they came. That big that three-point attempt by Lindsay Lettingham from the corner was halfway down, didn't fall.
Yeah, if that shot falls, I think they had it down to 9, like you said, and a three-point jumper makes it 6, but just not meant to be tonight for the Cougars in every sense of that expression. Congratulations, though. Soon to be in order for the Laurier Golden Hawks. Will inbound from underneath the Laurier basket with just under a minute left here.
We should probably grab Mallory Kohlmeyer after the game.
Mallory, and I think we'll talk to Mazarol as well. Do a little dual interview. Lettingham for three. Back rim. Rebound, and the Cougars aren't going to go away without a fight here. They're going to foul and make Wilfrid Laurier shoot some free throws.
Well, when your season's on the line like the Cougars is, you've got to extend that foul zone a little bit. You might not normally do it with a 13-point deficit, 51 seconds up in the fourth. As the fans start to file out of the CKHS.
Mancino, short on the first. Well, Braden, I guess if the Cougars don't get that at-large berth, this will be their final game of the season, and I mean, it'll be a disappointment for this team that is getting used to making that trip to Nationals, but...
Yeah, not the way Gabby Geisen would want to end her five-year Cougar career.
It was a tough year, though. I mean, injuries, you see two girls on the bench right now that might have made a difference, both here and at the Canada West Championships, Brittany Reed and Ann Mercer. As a foul is called here on Regina, and free throws coming up again for Wilfrid Laurier.
That one, a loose ball foul called on Lettingham as she went for the rebound. So Laurier will become just the second team to win at the CKHS this year on the road. Number one ranked Saskatchewan being the other.
Cougars picked a terrible time to lose their second home game of the year. But maybe that near-perfect home record will get them a berth at large into the CIS National Championship.
I'm glad I don't have to make that vote, Adam. Be tough to pick between those two good teams.
They announce all this tomorrow?
I believe it is, yeah. It's Mazarol elevates to block that three-pointer from Lettingham.
Now it's Mazarol. It'll be one last possession, you'd think, here for Wilfrid Laurier before they'll start celebrating. They turn it over. And now Lettingham is fouled. She'll go to the line. Seconds left in this one. No free throws yet for the Cougars. It'll be Joanna Zalashek driving right down the paint. Not really contested. Still misses the easy layup, and that's going to do it. Laurier is going to the CIS National Championships, Braden. They'll celebrate in hostile territory, but they will celebrate, and the Cougars, a dejected bunch on that sideline.
Now for Laurier, it was Mallory Kohlmeyer leading all players with 25 points. Krista Mancino ended up with 21. Kimberly Yeldon comes out of nowhere to score 14 for Laurier. And Felicia Mazarol had 12 points, 5 assists, and that one block late. For the Cougars, it was Lindsay Lettingham. She scored 16. Carly Graham had 13 for the Cougs. And Joanna Zalashak had 11.
Let's take a quick break. We're going to go grab some players and talk courtside here on SSN Canada. All right, post-game here. The Wilfrid Laurier Golden Hawks are off to the CIS National Championships. Felicia Mazarol and Mallory Kohlmeyer, you guys played a pretty impressive game here in hostile territory. We'll start with you, Mallory. You absolutely went off, especially in that first half. Talk about winning a big game here on the road and making that trip to Nationals.
Yeah, I mean, it's huge. It's my last year, so... I just thought this could be my last game, so I just had to go out and give it my all. I was a little off yesterday in our game, so just took a lot of focus, and I just needed to forget about last night and focus on tonight.
Now, Felicia, I mean, you, especially in the second half, really controlled the offense for your team and then ran away from the Cougars. It was close after 20 minutes. What did you guys do differently in the second half to really pull away?
I'd say we started on our defense. Our first half defense was kind of shaky, but our second half defense was really executed and very, very, very hard.
Mallory, you guys come in to a tough place to win, just the second loss for the Cougars at home. Now you're going to Nationals. Do you think winning this game here, a couple of the games this weekend, will help you prepare for maybe bigger things to come?
Oh, absolutely. I mean, we always like to take it one game at a time, but... it always, how you come out of the last game always affects how you go into the next game. So this weekend was huge for us, and, we're just building, and it's March, and we're still getting better. So we're looking forward to it.
Felicia, you're a first-year player, and you're going to keep playing, of course. Is it cool to win this game and make sure these fifth-year players get to keep playing?
Yeah, it's very cool. I mean, I didn't want it to be their last game, so we kind of left it all on the floor to give them another chance to play next weekend. So.
All right, guys. I'll let you go and celebrate the win. Good luck next weekend. And thanks, everyone, for tuning in tonight. Wilfrid Laurier off to the CIS Nationals. Thanks for watching on SSN.